My name is Nuno Alves. I'm the chef at Tavola Restaurant in Dorchester. We're located at 1918 Dorchester Avenue. So today we'll be making fresh mozzarella. So I've started here in a pot with a gallon of milk that has been reached up to 91 degrees. And then now we will be adding our rennet. So you want a quarter teaspoon of rennet, or you could use a tablet and crush it. I prefer this, it's easier to measure. We're gonna put a quarter cup of warm water in it to dissolve. Use the same spoon. We also have citric acid. And I'm going to add the citric acid first. Spoon. Just going to give it a really good stir. And this is going to take about 2 to 3 minutes, and this should start curdling a little bit. So we've started to curdle, so after we've added the citric acid to it. And now we will be adding the rennet that's been dissolved. So I'm gonna slowly pour this in here. Make sure you got all of it. And now we're gonna stir this for about 2 to 3 minutes just to get the rennet in there dissolved really well. And then we're gonna set it aside for about 45 minutes and it should block up. So the cheese has been sitting for an hour now. I've kept the temperature at 88 degrees to 91 degrees here. So I will take the thermometer out, and I'm going to cut the curd right now. Oh, beautiful. Pretty much you're just cutting it through so all the whey and all the protein gets out, and it's going to be easier to scoop. So you know it's easier to pick up, because you won't be able to pick up one whole big mass to strain out. So this is just going to make it easier for you. And as you can see, it came out really, really nice. And then I have cheesecloth and a strainer in a bowl. This always helps to get more of the cheese in without losing it. And as you can see how I'm picking it all up and drain up as much as possible. Awesome. So from here you can actually tie it and hang it if you'd like. Or you could just leave it right in here and store it at room temp. And as you can see how much more whey is left in here. So as you can see that the curd is starting to get dry, and it'll get a little bit drier and more stiffer. But the key part is to find is these really nice grains that you see in here. This is like exactly what you were looking for. So I'm just gonna let this tie this up really nice and let it drain for an hour and a half, just so that all the whey comes out of the curd. And then we'll get right into the next process. So our mozzarella has been hanging for at least an hour and a half. So got so much more whey out of it. So we're just gonna put that right back in the same pot. Now we're gonna get to our stretching of the mozzarella. As you can see, this is a really nice, good mass. And I'm just gonna break it up because you want it to melt evenly when you add the hot water. So I'm just finishing about crumbling the last bits here. I'm gonna add some water. Water's been at 160 degrees. Just gonna throw it at the back in the front of the bowl just to get everything heated up properly and evenly. We're gonna start off with 2 ladlesfuls for right now. Just work this around in there. So the process is I'm melting the curd back up and getting it back together so I can stretch it and form it into a mozzarella ball, which you want to continue doing this about 10 minutes until it all comes together. If the bowl gets too much water in the bowl, you just drain it out. Just keep your sieve back here to catch any excess mozzarella that comes out. Save that. Key part is keeping this nice and warm and it will melt up. When I was ladling the water, I did not add it directly to the cheese. I added it around the bowl to get everything nice and hot and evenly distributed. Definitely do not want to get it right directly into the curd because some curds will melt faster than the other. Key part is to maintain as many curds as possible and doing it nice and gently. As you can see, this is coming out really nice right now. You can see the nice rips in it, really cool. That's exactly what you want to come together. Just gonna. Sometimes it makes it easier if you use the back of the spoon to stretch it. So we're at that stage where it's the balls, mozzarella starts shining and ripping. You're getting these nice layers, as you can see. This is exactly what you want. And I'm going to start forming balls. I have some salted water here. This is about a quart of water that I bring up to a boil. Put a half a cup of salt in it, dissolved it, and then cooled it down. So now this is ready to go. This is what's going to season your mozzarella balls. And then from here, to shape them, I actually shape them in my hands. Just drop it right in here. I'm just going to repeat this process. The balls don't have to be perfect. I got small hands, you got big hands, you make big balls. That's what you want. So I'm just forming up the last ball here right now. I'm going to drop it into the salt water solution. A lot of times back in the old country, they actually used to use natural seawater in here instead of diluting their own water. And you actually can actually throw a little whey in there to give it a little bit more flavor if you'd like. Just keeps it all consistent and nice. So this is one of my favorite parts of this day. I'm gonna grab one of these guys. Grab my knife here real quick, cut it in half. You can see how it's developed these beautiful strands inside. Delicious. So I'm going to try it out. I'm actually going to add a little salt to mine. Right on the cutting board. This is the best part of the morning. A little olive oil. Breakfast of champions. So good.